Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et plentes, in ac lacrimarum vave. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome on this Tuesday, the sixth week of the year. Last week, we took a walk through the book of Genesis, creation, the fall of our first parents, Adam and Eve. If you've been following my podcast, I've been focusing on that in my preaching. Yesterday, we had Cain and Abel, the utter unraveling of a human relationship. What happens when a family has bloodshed and how it rips apart relationships. What began with Adam and Eve and their fall to temptation now increased yesterday. And then we kind of skip over a little bit, and now we are in the well-known story of Noah and the ark. This is where God sees that the evil that had begun with Adam and Eve and was seen with Cain and Abel now has spread throughout the world. And so God has a plan to wash it clean. I'll talk about that in the homily today. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us call to mind our sin, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sin and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Genesis. When the Lord saw how great was man's wickedness on earth, and how no desire that his heart conceived was ever anything but evil, he regretted that he had made man on the earth, and his heart was grieved. So the Lord said, I will wipe out from the earth the men whom I have created, and not only the men, but also the beasts and the creeping things and the birds of the air. For I am sorry that I made them. But Noah found favor with the Lord. Then the Lord said to Noah, Go into the ark, you and all your household, for you alone in this age have I found to be truly just. Of every clean animal, take with you 7 pairs, a male and a female. And of the unclean animals, 1 pair, a male and his mate. Likewise, of every clean bird of the air, 7 pairs, a male and a female. And of all the unclean birds, 1 pair, a male and a female. Thus you will keep their issue alive over all the earth. 7 days from now, I will bring rain down on the earth for 40 days and 40 nights. And so I will wipe out from the surface of the earth every moving creature that I have made. Noah did just as the Lord had commanded him. As soon as the 7 days were over, the waters of the flood came upon the earth. The word of the Lord. The response, the Lord will bless his people with peace. The Lord will bless his people with peace. Give to the Lord, you sons of God. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Adore the Lord in holy attire. The Lord will bless his people with peace. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The Lord over vast waters. The voice of the Lord is mighty. The voice of the Lord is majestic. The Lord will bless his people with peace. The God of glory thunders, and in his temple all say, glory. The Lord is enthroned upon the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever. The Lord will bless his people with peace.
Loves me will keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. The disciples had forgotten to bring bread, and they had only 1 loaf with them in the boat. Jesus enjoined them, "Watch out, guard against the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod." They concluded among themselves that it was because they had no bread. When he became aware of this, he said to them, "Why do you conclude that it was because you have no bread? Do you not yet understand or comprehend? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes and not see, ears and not hear? Do you not remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000? How many wicker baskets full of fragments you picked up?" They answered him, 12. "When I broke the 7 loaves for the 4,000, how many full baskets of fragments did you pick up?" They answered him, 7. He said to them, "Do you still not understand?" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I went to graduate seminary at St. John's in Collegeville, Minnesota. It was an incredible experience. And a lot of things happen on that campus, and there are a lot of people in residence and scholars, artisans, craftsmen. One day I stumbled into the pottery studio run by a guy named Richard Bresnahan. He's a master potter, and he would take students. And I would watch how these students, they would learn the craft, but obviously with pottery you can do all the technique and the theory you want, but until you're at that wheel and you're shaping that clay, you really don't know what you're doing. And so these students, they had their wheels, and of course the master potter, he's off in a corner and he's making these beautiful things, and the different students would work on a technique. And I would watch, and you know, you could just go in there and have a cup of coffee and watch what they would do. And I'd see how these students were working on something, and sometimes what they made was exactly what they wanted. They got the technique just right, the thickness just right, the shaping just right, cut it, took it off the wheel, and got it ready to go and be fired in the kiln. But not always. Sometimes they'd be at the wheel and it wasn't looking right, they try. So they stop and they just take that, what was beginning to be something beautiful, and they just mashed it all together and started over. That they had looked at what they were forming and didn't like what they saw. So they began again. Now we've been following for the last week God's gift of creation. And it begins beautifully. The heavens, the earth, the sun, the moon, the living things. And God said, it's good. And for a span of time, the beauty and power of creation in its perfect glory. Well, then the shoe drops. And our first parents fall in their temptation, and sin enters into our world. And then we see how yesterday with Cain and Abel, how that evil intensifies and rips apart relationships between ourselves and the Lord. And now today we see how it is just spread. It's everywhere. And so here's God regretting the beauty and power of creation. And so we're going to just wash the whole thing clean, except for Noah. Noah found favor with God. Noah was righteous. He's a good guy. And so this ark, this vessel that is going to save creation by keeping the seeds of those living beings and that small family will be spared while the floodwaters wash the earth clean. It's a powerful image. And you know, we all know the story of Noah when we grew up as kids in our Bible books, right? We all know it. But there's a beautiful and powerful image behind this of the cleansing power of God when evil becomes so great it needs to be dealt with. And that's exactly what the Lord does. Washes it clean. Starts again. But you only do that once. Because we as disciples of Jesus know that the Lord continues to look at the weakness, the wickedness, the evil that we do. And now there's a new kind of cleansing, a new flood. It's the blood and water that flowed down the side of the cross when the spear poked into the side of our Lord. The water that flowed down, the blood that was poured forth, that floods our world with a grace to wash away our sins, to cleanse us of our wickedness, to help us turn away from whatever is destructive, whatever might be ripping apart at the fabric of our relationships, of our lives, of our encounter with God. God comes to cleanse the earth. And it's done in Jesus. And that cleansing grace, a floodwater so great, can spare us when we repent of our sins and turn to the Lord. What we see here with Noah, this beautiful witness of how God does come to bring a solution when evil runs amok, we can take to heart that God has come with a solution in Jesus for us. So folks, today, is there anything in our hearts that needs to be washed clean? Is there anything in our life today that needs to be healed and renewed? Is there anything today that we know is not worthy of heaven and we need to bring that to the Lord and say, Lord, help me here. Cleanse me here. May your precious blood wash me clean of that sin. Renew me in your grace and send me forth out into the world to be your son or daughter, sharing your love, sharing your good news. Noah's life becomes for us an example of how we can be spared when we turn to the Lord. So may we turn to the Lord this day. May we account for what needs to change. And may we allow that grace that comes from heaven to heal our hearts. God bless you all. We pray this day for the church, Pope Francis, our bishops, that they will lead and guide us to turn to the Lord for the healing grace we need. We pray to the Lord. I keep reading the story about Turkey and Syria and the devastation from those earthquakes. It reminds us, folks, that I don't know what tomorrow brings. So we pray for those who are grieving the loss of their loved ones. We pray for those who've been affected by tragedies. We pray that we as a global community can work together to bring comfort and healing. We pray to the Lord. Lord knows we pray for Ukraine, for all those places around the world troubled by poverty, violence, and of course war. That the Prince of Peace will calm hearts and minds. We pray to the Lord. We all got people who are sick. We all got people in need. We all got people who could use a little healing, body, mind, heart, and soul. We pray to the Lord. For the intention of this Mass, by Michael, we pray to the Lord. For all of you at home, for the prayers you offer in the comment line, and for all of us, the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord. Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord. O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, and choose from our homes those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us.
Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons.
Obtain for us many more. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that we should give you thanks and praise, O God, Almighty Father, for all you do in this world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ. For though the human race is divided by dissension and discord, yet we know that by testing us, you change our hearts to prepare them for reconciliation. Even more, by your Spirit, you move human hearts, that enemies may speak to each other again, adversaries join hands, and peoples seek to meet together.
By the working of your power, it comes about, O Lord, that hatred is overcome by love. Revenge gives way to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. Therefore, as we give you ceaseless thanks with the choirs of heaven, we cry out to your majesty on earth, and without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also, together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. May he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, James our Bishop, all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. It's quite the amen. With the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us stand to pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Have a great day.